Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss velocity analysis of any link which is in any mechanism by instantaneous center method. So let's start the discussion of instantaneous center method for determining the velocity of any particular link or to determine the velocity at any point on a link in a mechanism. So here first I'm going to discuss some basic term which is related to velocity analysis of mechanism. Then I will discuss about the instantaneous center method. So as we know, velocity, we know it is called the rate of change of position with respect to time. If we are considering any body which is moving with particular velocity, so velocity we can determine by the change in position of that body with respect to time. If we are considering any body which is placed at point A, and if it is moving from point A and it is reaching the end position, that is B. And here this body is going to cover X distance in a particular time period. If we are considering this body is taking time T second to cover this X meter or X centimeter distance from A to B. Unit we can decide accordingly. So here the body is in movement and it is covering a particular distance in a particular time. So this body is changing its position and this body is in motion. So this body will move as per the velocity concept. Here change in position with respect to time t. So change in position we will consider in terms of x and time we will consider in terms of t. So change in position means dx and change in time, that is dt. So dx by dt will represent the velocity if the body is moving linearly. If there is a linear path or rectilinear path in that particular condition, the velocity analysis we can do by dx by dt. So there are two types of velocity we consider when any body is moving linearly or along the rectilinear path. So dx by dt will represent the linear velocity. But if the body is not moving along this rectilinear path, if the body is in rotation or it is moving along a curve, so here, this is the diagram which is representing the rotation of any particular body. Here, if we are considering the body is at point A and if it is moving along this curve, this dashed line is representing a curve. So if any body is moving along this curve and it is reaching the position B in a particular time period, so during rotation, we consider velocity as an angular velocity. And this angular velocity we consider in terms of angular displacement of body. This displacement we will consider as angular displacement, which is represented by theta. So here with theta, and if it is taking time t to cover up this curve distance AB, so the angular velocity we will consider as in terms of omega, and omega will be d theta by dt. So this is the basic concept of velocity. And if we want to determine velocity of any particular point on any link which is in mechanism, so the analysis of velocity of that particular point with respect to another points in the links in a mechanism, that is called the velocity analysis. So in easy terms, we can say to analyze the velocity at different point on any particular body at different position and at different time, so that particular analysis is called the velocity analysis. Now here you can see this diagram. Here we are considering one link or one object, that is AB. So if we are considering this body is moving with two motion. If the body is moving linearly as well as there is also a rotational motion, so that particular motion we will consider as the combined motion. That is the combination of linear motion or rectilinear motion as well as the rotation. For example, if we see any wheel or any roller which is moving on a flat surface, so that particular wheel move with two motion, linear motion plus rotational motion or the curvilinear motion. So, if we are considering both motion in any kind of body which is moving on a flat surface, so that is called the combined motion for that particular body. And if any body is moving linearly as well as with rotational motion, so it will move with some velocity and it will have some acceleration. So, we have to analyze the velocity of that body at different point for the rotation as well as for the linear motion. So, here you can see this particular diagram. Here we are considering this body AB. This is the initial position of body AB. And this dashed line here, this straight line is representing the linear motion of body AB. Now, if this particular link or body AB is moving linearly and it is reaching the point A1V1. So, this is the change position of body AB during the linear motion. Now, so this is representing linear motion or rectilinear motion of AB, and change position we are considering B1. So, it will cover up some distance in a particular time. Now, after this point B1, if this body is moving from B1 to B1 dash and it is moving by the rotation, so this rotation we will consider about a particular point that is called the center. So here one point will not move, that is A1, and here this B1 point is moving with the help of rotation and it is reaching the position B1 dash. So this particular body B1 is moving with respect to center of rotation, that is considered as A1, and it is reaching the position B1 dash. Now here we cannot define the type of motion for this particular body if it is moving with linear motion as well as the rotation, if the motion is gradual or if the speed is very slow. So, here let us consider the motion is gradual. So, in that condition, here you can see this point A and B is changing its position to A1, B1 by the linear motion. And here this point B1 is changing its position to B1 dash with the help of rotation. So, in that case, we can see this point B is moving faster than point A. As per this particular path, so, B is traveling more distance compared to A. So, B is moving faster than point A. And here, if we are considering gradual motion, so we cannot exactly define which motion is linear motion and which motion is rotation. So, here we will consider the total motion under the pure rotation. So, in pure rotation, we will consider only one type of motion, that is called the rotation. Here, linear motion we will consider as the combination of, here we are considering two motion, rectilinear motion and rotation. So, in pure rotation, we only consider rotation. But this particular example, we will consider as the combined motion. Combined motion means there are two or more than two motions are involved. So, here if we are considering the motion is gradual and this motion will be combined motion, and if we are seeing here, you can see the point B is moving faster than point A. So, the distance traveled by point B is greater than the distance traveled by point A. So, in that condition, we can see this point B is moving along the rotation. So, this combined motion for the gradual motion we will consider as the pure rotation. So, if we are considering pure rotation, so the body will move about one particular point, that is called the center of rotation. And the body is moving about one center of rotation. So that particular center of rotation we call instantaneous center of rotation or virtual center. So, instantaneous center we can define about which any particular body is moving under the pure rotation. Here, point B is faster than point A. So, this motion we'll consider as a pure rotation. And in pure rotation, this particular body AB is moving about one center. This complete body will move. Only point B will not move. This complete body will change its position under the pure rotation. So, the point about which this complete body is moving, that is called the instantaneous center of rotation or the virtual center. So, here if we want to define the velocity analysis for any particular body which is under the combined motion, and that combined motion if we are considering as a pure rotation, if one point is moving faster than the another point, so this diagram, or with the help of this diagram, I will explain you the velocity analysis as well as the concept of instantaneous center for any particular body. So, here you can see this diagram, we are considering AB as a link. This AB we are considering as one body, and if we want to define the combined effect of rotation and translation, so we have to define this particular body under pure rotation, and if we want to define the instantaneous center for this particular body, so here you can see we are considering pure rotation condition. So, this is the initial position, A and B are the initial position, and if this body is changing its position from AB to A1, B1. So, this body will move along a curve with one center. So, if we are considering this particular point A is moving along this curve AA1, and the chord for this curve we are considering AA1. You can see this is the chord, and this point B is also moving. So, this BB1 is representing the chord for this curve which is made by B to reach the position B1. So, here these chords we are considering for AA1 and BB1. This is representing the motion of AB. Now, if we draw a perpendicular on the chord, or if we draw a bisector perpendicularly for this chord AA1 and BB1. So, this line is representing the bisector of this chord BB1 perpendicular to it, and here you can see this is represented, or this is initiated at point N. N is the initial point where we are drawing this bisector perpendicular to BB1 chord. Now, let us take this chord AA1, and if we draw one bisector on this particular chord AA1, which is begin from point M, so we will mark perpendicular to AA1 from point M. Now, where these two perpendicular bisector are intersecting. So, this is the intersection point of these bisector. So, the point where these two bisector intersecting, that particular point we will consider as the instantaneous center for this particular body AB about which the body is rotating. So, by this way we can find out the instantaneous center for any particular body which is under the rotation. So, this is called, this particular I is called the instantaneous center. And this particular bisector about which we are defining the position of instantaneous center, that is called the instantaneous axis. So, this IN or IM we will consider as the instantaneous axis. which is representing the position of instantaneous center, and it is perpendicular to the chord BB1 and AA1 on the position or on the change position of A to A1 and B to B1. So, this is all about the instantaneous center and instantaneous axis. Now, here we are considering for the one position of AB or link AB. Now, if this AB is continuously changing its position, so here the first position of AB is this. Now, if this link AB is changing its position, so in that case, the position of instantaneous center is also changing. So, here the first instantaneous center we are considering here. Now, this AB is changing its position like this. So, here this angle theta is different and this angle theta is different. So, this AB is changing its position and this AB is continuously changing its position. So, for this change position of AB, the instantaneous center will different. So, if we are considering this center is I1. So, for this change position, we will define the center I2 and for third position, we will define the center I3 and continuously for the continuous change position for AB, we will define the different instantaneous center. So, the locus defined or locus formed to join all the instantaneous center is defined as it is called centrode, locus formed by joining all instantaneous center for change position of the link, it is called centrode. So, if we draw or if we join all the instantaneous center for the change position of AB, so this particular locus is defined as centrode. So, these are the basic terms which we are going to use for the velocity analysis of any particular point on the link in a mechanism with respect to another point. Now, let's define different types of centrode also. So, there are two types of centrode we consider. One is the space centrode and another is the body centrode. So, with the help of diagram, you can easily understand the concept of space centrode and body centrode. So, here you can see one body A1, B1. You can see here this is the body A1, B1 and this is the initial position of this body. And if this body is moving about one particular point under the pure rotation and this body is continuously changing its position. So, here the change position of the body is also given by A2 and B2. So, this is the change position of the body. Now, here if we draw the instantaneous center for this body A1, B1. So, you can see here this is represented by point I1. Now, second point, if this body A1, B1 is changing its position to A2, B2 with some velocity. So, this change instantaneous center for the change position of the body is defined by the I2. So, here we can easily define the position of instantaneous center for change position of this particular body A1, B1 to A2, B2. So, here you can see there are number of instantaneous center we have I1, I2, I3. If we are defining the third position of A1, B1 as A3, B3. So, I3 we will form. So, here we will define the centrode to join these different instantaneous center. So, space centrode we can define as the locus of instantaneous center in the space during definite motion of the body. In space, if we are defining the locus of instantaneous center for a definite motion of the body, this body should be in motion. This point A1 with some velocity, this point B1 we will consider with some velocity, and with this velocity, this body is changing its position to A2 and B2. So, there is a definite motion for the body we can define with the help of velocity and acceleration. And if this body is moving with some velocity and if it is defined by a different instantaneous center, pure rotation if we are defining, so to join all the locus in the space that represent the space centrode. Now, there is another centrode we define as the body centroid. So body centroid we generally define as the locus of instantaneous center to the body itself. All the instantaneous center to the body itself we generally define by the body centroid. And here you can see these body centroid we will define here in terms of C1 and C2. Here you can see if we define the instantaneous center by the body itself or to the body itself, so this is defined by the C1 and C2. Here you can see the C1 is coinciding with I1 for the first position of the body. And here for the second position of the body, the C2 is not coinciding with I2. In that particular condition, the triangle formed by these two positions of the body are not equivalent. If both the triangles formed by the, if we are defining this instantaneous center, so there is a triangle formed by the body A1, B1, I1 and A2, B2, I2. And if both the triangles are equivalent, in that condition C1 and C2 will lie on both the instantaneous center. But if both the triangles are not equivalent, in that condition C1 and C2 position will change. Here C1 is coinciding with I1, but C2 is not coinciding with I2. In that case, both the triangles are not identical. So, if we are considering this particular condition, in that case only, both the centers C1 and C2 will be considerable at I1 and I2. If it is not identical, in that case, C1 and C2 will lie on different path or on different curve, and that curve will be represented by the body centroid. And number of position of these C1, C2 or different points on the body centroid we can define by the different position of this body A1, B1. Like first position is A2, B2. So we can define the position of C2 in terms of the triangles. Now third position is A3, B3. Fourth position is A4, B4. So here we will define the instantaneous center for all the position of the A1, B1 as well as we can define the instantaneous center or we can define the position of C1 and C2 in terms of identical condition of these two triangles. So locus of joining all the points C1, C2, C3, C4 for all the change position, that is defined as the body centroid. So this is the concept of space centroid and body centroid. Now move toward the next point, that is how we can define the velocity at a particular point on the link. So basically there are two methods we generally prefer to define the velocity at a particular point on a link. First method is instantaneous center method. Second method is relative velocity method. So instantaneous center method I am going to discuss here. This instantaneous center method is the simplest method to define the velocity at a particular point on a link, where we can define the velocity of any particular point with respect to another point which has the magnitude and direction of the velocity both. Here we are considering one point which has magnitude and direction both and another point which has only direction. So to define the velocity of another point, we can use the first point with velocity with magnitude and acceleration. So this particular instantaneous center method we generally use to define the velocity at a particular point on a link when one point have the magnitude and direction for the velocity and another point does not have magnitude, it will always have one direction only. So for this condition we will prefer the instantaneous center method. Now second method is relative velocity method, so that I will discuss later. So let's discuss how we can define the velocity at a particular point on a link by instantaneous center method. So if we talk about instantaneous center method, so we have to define one instantaneous center for a particular link for different position under the pure rotation condition. And this instantaneous center method we can only define when any body is moving in one plane only. So, these two points you have to remember when you are using the instantaneous center method to define the velocity of particular point. First point, this method is only applicable when we are considering displacement of the link or displacement of a point in a single plane. That plane can be xy plane, yz plane, xz plane, anything, but it should be one plane. And second thing which you have to remember, that is the body should be under pure rotation. The body should be in one plane, or the displacement should be in one plane, and the body should be under the pure rotation. So here, with the help of one diagram, I am going to discuss how we can define the velocity with the help of instantaneous center method at a particular point on a link. So here we will consider two points on a rigid body. So here we are considering one rigid body. It is defined by, here you can see this blue arbitrary shape, that is defining a body or a rigid body. And here we are considering two points on a rigid body. Point A and B we are considering as the point on a rigid body. Now, how we can define the velocity of these two points with the help of instantaneous center method? So here, two considerations we have to take. One point should have magnitude and direction of the velocity, and other point should have only direction. So with the help of instantaneous center method, we can define the velocity of the second point. So here, if we are considering these two points and this body is under pure rotation, so let us consider the body is rotating in a particular direction with one instantaneous center with angular velocity omega. So here we will consider the displacement also. So displacement we will consider in terms of angular displacement during the rotation. So here we are considering two points A and B. Now if we define the pure rotation and if we are considering the combined motion, so we have to define the linear velocity also. So in pure rotation, if there are gradual motion we are considering, so we can consider the combined motion. So here, if we define the linear velocity of these two points, so here it is defined by VA. So VA is representing the linear velocity of point A, and VB is representing the linear velocity of point B. Because it is in rotation, so direction will be different for both the points. So here, this point A is representing the velocity in this direction. This is the direction of the velocity component for point A, and this is the direction for velocity component at point B. And direction of VA and VB we can define by two angles, alpha and beta. Here you can see in this diagram, this alpha is representing the direction of VA from point A, and this beta is representing the direction of point B, or direction of the velocity component of this point B. So alpha and beta is representing the direction of velocity component VA and VB. Now here we are considering velocity component VA with magnitude and direction, and VB with direction only. So here we have to define the magnitude of velocity component VB. So here at this particular point, VB we have to define in terms of magnitude. So first of all, here we have to define the instantaneous center for this particular pure rotation, because here we are considering pure rotation, and we have to define the velocity component of point B or magnitude of velocity VB in terms of or with respect to point A, which has magnitude and direction. So we will define the instantaneous center for this particular body which is under the rotation, and this instantaneous center we will define by, here you can see these two lines. So what we will do, we will draw a perpendicular on this particular velocity component or velocity vector Va. This is representing the direction of motion of point A, Va. So, perpendicular to this Va, we will draw a line that is represented by this dashed line. Similarly, on point B, perpendicular to Vb, we will draw a line. So, this line is representing the perpendicular on Vb. Now, both the line are joining or intersecting at one point. So, this particular point is represented as the instantaneous center for the pure rotation of this particular body, and it is defined by Ai and Bi. Now, here you can see these two points we are considering on a single body. So, these two points will not be in relative motion with each other. These two body will move about one point I in pure rotation. That is called the virtual center or instantaneous center. Now, how we can define the velocity of Vb with the help of this instantaneous center? So, what we will do, we will resolve both the velocity components. Now, if we are resolving the velocity components, so, here you can see this AB is representing a particular link, and if we want to define the velocity component along AB, here for AB we are defining the velocity component. So, velocity component along AB, it will be VA cos alpha, because alpha is defining the position, and this VB we will define along AB in terms of VB cos beta. So, both the angles will be equivalent. So, here if we are considering both the term VA cos alpha and VB cos beta, so both are in same direction, so both will be equivalent. So, here if we are resolving this component, so it will be VA cos alpha, and that will be equals to Vb cos beta. So, here this, with the help of this equation, we can define the term Va by Vb, that is equals to cos beta by cos alpha. So, we can write this term as sin 90 minus beta by sin 90 minus alpha. Now, here if we form these angles on a triangle, here we have this triangle AIB. So, this particular angle, if we are representing in terms of cos beta, so this particular angle we will define in terms of sin 90 minus beta. And this is our cos alpha. So, this particular angle will be 90 minus alpha. This particular angle, this particular angle is beta. So, this will be 90 minus beta, because this particular angle is 90 and this angle is alpha, so it will be 90 minus alpha. So, our equation will be like this. Now, if we apply Lamy's theorem on this triangle AIB, so, as per the Lamy's theorem, this equation will be AI by sin 90 minus beta, that is equals to BI by sin 90 minus alpha. You can see here, this is the triangle. So, this angle we have alpha, this is 90 minus alpha. This angle we have beta. So, this will be 90. So, this will be 90 minus beta. So, here we have both the angle. So, we can define this particular triangle with the help of Lamy's theorem. So, AI, and in front of AI, the angle is 90 minus beta. So, it will be sin 90 minus beta. BI, and in front of BI, the angle is 90 minus alpha. So, it will be sin 90 minus alpha. So with the help of Lamy's theorem, we can define this term AI by sine 90 minus beta, that is equals to BI by sine 90 minus alpha. And we can define this term . So this will be our equation. Now we have sine 90 minus beta by sine 90 minus alpha as VA by VB. So this will be our equation. So in that case, we can define the ratio of VA by VB, that is equals to AI by PI. So with the help of this particular equation, we can define the value of VB or magnitude of VB with the help of VA, BI and AI. This BI and AI we can measure with the help of diagram. Now, VA by AI, that is equals to VB by VI, we can define by the equation. So this particular term is representing the angle of velocity for that particular point A and B. So this is representing, VA is representing omega into AI and VB is representing omega into BI. So with the help of this equation, we can also define the value of VB, which is not given. Now here you can see one more point, the point C. This is the point C which we are considering on the same body. So if we want to define the velocity in magnitude and direction for this particular point C, so we can define with the help of same concept. Here we will define the instantaneous center and we will use one particular point about which, or the point where, like if we are considering point A, so we will use the magnitude and direction of point A to define the velocity at point C. If we want to define the velocity at point C, so the equation will be, one more term will add here, VC by CI. So with the help of this particular equation, we can also define the velocity at third point on the same link. Here CI is representing the distance of point C with instantaneous center. So on the basis of this particular concept, we can define two points which is related to instantaneous center method to define the velocity at a particular point in a kinematic link. That is, first point is, which is well known, which I already explained, that is if velocity at any point A is known in magnitude and direction and velocity of point B is known in direction only, so velocity at any other point which is lying on the same link can be determined in magnitude and direction. So here this particular velocity B we can define with the help of magnitude and direction of velocity at point A. And if we want to define the velocity of any other point which is placed on the same link in magnitude and direction, so we can define by the magnitude and direction of point A and magnitude and direction of point B. Now, second point which you have to remember in terms of this instantaneous center method, that is magnitude of velocity of the point on a rigid link are inversely proportional to the distance from point to the instantaneous center and perpendicular to the line joining the point to the instantaneous center. So this particular point is applicable on previous equation. This is the equation which is representing the second point. So this is all about the instantaneous center method to define the velocity at a particular point in magnitude and direction. With the help of this particular concept, we can define the velocity at any point on a link. Thank you so much.